Hi, I'm John McAllister, and Michael Stroker here asked me to introduce his show, Settle It on the Screen.
Views expressed in the following show are for entertainment purposes only. They are not necessarily the views of Twin Galaxies, HD Films, or any other affiliates. Yo, ladies and gentlemen, well, everybody, welcome to Settle It on the Screen. Happy Halloween. I am Echo the Dolphin here, joining you for the third consecutive year of Settle It on the Screen Halloween. Nothing is going to be spooky. Well, maybe something a little bit later be a little bit spooky that I'm going to talk about. Bunch of stuff. We got lots of stuff, so I should really get to it. My co-host, I don't know where he is. Nick Auslander will be here shortly. We got two guests lined up today. We got Darrell Sampson from Canada, one of the organizers of the King of 94 tournaments. He's in Skype. And then we have Isaiah Triforce Johnson. He'll be joining us in the second half, and we're going to talk about an event from Ottumwa celebrating the 35th anniversary of the Twin Galaxies Arcade that Walter set up years ago. So I'm going to get right to it. Darrell, you're going to help me with some world records, I'm assuming?
Yeah, I'll read a couple for you.
All right, cool. Nick's supposed to read the tough ones, but I guess I'm going to have to slaughter some people's names. So here we go. World records for the week of October 28th, 2016. Go ahead, Darrell. You get the first one.
Okay. So we have Clay Kurzewski. Hopefully I got that right. Nintendo Entertainment System, California Games, NTSC, half pipe points, 26,143. I used to love that game, but it was on the Sega remember the Sega Master System?
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
California Games on that? I used to play that all the time.
I used to play California Games on the Atari 7800. That was my favorite version. I love the BMX. I hated the surfing. The half pipe was kind of fun, but the BMX on California Games for 7800 is my favorite. One thing, I guess I should have read the score, because this one has gone back and forth quite a bit. There's been quite a few submissions for it, so I don't know if that's going to be the top score. I know Mark Cohen had a submission in there. Clay actually had a submission, too. I think he just he bested himself with this 26,143. So that's a nice job, Clay. Let's see if I can read the next ones without Nick's help. The Amstrad CPC computer. Great game, Bomb Jack, marathon type rules, 665,090 points from Pablo Forsen of Alicante, Spain. I'm not an English major, I'm a math major, so they're nice job, Pablo. It is also great to see just one of these computers being resubmitted on some of these old tracks. Awesome job. Let's see here.
Someone just said I look like John Belushi.
Oh, that's pretty awesome. Hey, Nick, you here?
Sorry, I'm coming off the bench, man.
Oh, he's off the bench. He's here.
Shoot. Oh,
go
sorry.
Ahead, Nick. Shooting fire right there.
Can looks like it? We got Pete Hahn from Chicagoland, USA, which is in Illinois.
Yeah, it's me. You just call it Chicago.
Okay, Chicago.
Suburbs of Chicago.
Oh, it's like Metro Chicago. Mm. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Arcade, Polestar, highest score, 1,077,290. Congratulations, Pete.
Mr. Galloping Ghost himself.
Yep.
Pete Doc Hahn. Doc Mac builds the machines. Pete Hahn breaks them.
Yeah, that's what he does, man.
Yep.
Just punches them. You see his fist.
Yep. Congratulations to Kristen Apatowicz.
let's go with the Applewitz. Second one. Yeah.
Kristen Applewitz. Awesome in television.
Yeah, baby.
2,271 points. She was very excited about beating the world record. She beat it by like 40 or something. She had an unofficial best.
I think Utopia.
Yeah, it's like war.
I was going to say, that awesome. Is a.
Yeah.
So. That is not a common game.
That's nice, man. Yep. Kristen, and not to mention a woman.
Thank you.
We're not done with that today.
Really? Yeah. Oh, this is wonderful.
This is the only women gamers.
This is awesome. This is what we've been wanting this for, 2 years
forever,
now.
Yep.
Yeah.
Back to you, Darrell.
All right. Congratulations to Angela Stefanski from Seattle, Washington, Xbox 360 Live Arcade. Geometry Wars Retro Evolved in the Evolved mode. And for points, she had 1,026,735.
Awesome job, Angela. Welcome to the scoreboard. I see a few
that
other
is wonderful,
ones.
Angela. Nice.
I love that game. That's actually a score I tried to beat like four or five years
really?
Ago. But
oh, that long ago. Okay, yeah, that makes sense.
I love it. It's a better version of Robotron, in my opinion.
Well, it's hard to it's hard to make a worse version of Robotron.
So. And last but not least, remember, these aren't all the world records that were set in the past week. Congratulations to Daniel Desjardins, Frogs in Space on the Commodore 64. This is emulated, which means it's played on the computer.
Yeah.
99,284 points. Nice job,
that's
Daniel.
One. Nice, Dan.
And he's not only not the last world record we announced, but he is also
all right.
Stop giveaway gift card.
Been a long time.
And just right. Nice. I mean, to be honest. Just at the right timing. This
it really
was communicated
is.
A couple days ago.
Oh, beautiful.
Perfect timing for a Wingstop gift card, just to remind everybody
it
that
has been 4 months.
You can win also a Wingstop gift card just by,
random. It's
just
random.
By totally random
nice.
Beating
nice.
Just scores on the Twin Galaxies database.
Absolutely.
And I'm here joined by
veteran
Carlos Zambrano of the Chicago Cubs.
Yep.
How do you think your old team's going to do tonight?
I think they'll be all right. I mean, it's still tied. But, you know, it's two great teams, man. But National League's better than American League.
Everyone
always will
be.
Always will be. It can't be.
Yeah.
National League clubs have real baseball players on their team. Yeah. So.
And as Echo a Dolphin,
oh, yeah.
Carlos is kind of wish what my name was. So I'm a little envious of your costume. So I know. It's just I want to talk to you like this because then it actually looks like a dolphin for a little bit.
No, it's kind of awesome, Mike.
Okay.
Are
so
you guys
we got
both
lots
rooting for the Cubs?
I'm sorry?
Oh, yeah. God,
you guys
yeah.
both rooting for the Cubs?
Of course. We're from Detroit. We hate Cleveland.
Are you kidding me? Cleveland? Oh. I can't think of a city I despise worse than Cleveland.
Thanks for all of those. Thank you for all of us joining us tonight here on Skype, where we see a nice big crowd, probably some type of third or fifth feature.
Yeah, okay.
We got a lot in store tonight. We do have a used game giveaway.
Oh, my God.
Don't give it away.
Oh, don't give it away.
Because
sorry.
We got to. Because they might they might already have the game, so they might tune
it's
out.
Possible.
Here shortly, we're gonna talk to Halifax or Darrell. We keep calling you both.
Yeah, which name? Which would you rather go by?
That doesn't matter. Darrell's fine.
Nah, we'll probably go back and forth.
Okay, so Halifax.
Halifax is the screen name. We have shortly after we talk to him, we're gonna do a switching of the cameras, bringing our second guest in. Nick is gonna start playing Smash TV.
Yes.
And we're gonna
awesome
play guess Nick's score, and it's gonna be Price is Right rules. So
I like
basically, think of what score is Nick gonna get. If you go over what he gets, you don't win. So if you want to guess a dollar, you know, we're gonna ask for your entries. Please only guess once in the Skype when Nick does start the competition.
Cool.
And
I'm excited, and Nick are gonna start
unloading some of our game collection on you. So it's a used game. There are working games. Shipping is already included, all that good stuff. So it's just a little fun thing to do that the boys on Thursday night kind of do with gameaways and giveaways.
Cool.
So we're going to start doing that here and settle that on the screen.
We
so,
certainly have enough games to do.
Oh, yeah. We have plenty. We have enough copies of NHL 94
to do like
to
months.
Away. We have months and months. Yes, I mean, it's ridiculous. I have enough Sega Genesis to do at least a half a year of giveaways.
My God.
So we got Darrell here on the in Twin Galaxies Live 2.
Yep.
Thanks for joining us, the guy dressed in all Canadian stuff. Go
thanks
Canada.
Thanks for having me.
Nah, thanks for coming on, man. It's good to, good to talk to you again.
Yeah, we knew about this a couple weeks ago.
You know what? The last time I saw you guys. Well, actually, the only time I saw you guys was in Toronto at the tournament. And that was when Michael was ripping it up on the Sega Genesis. And Nick was, he was kind of ripping it up.
Not really. I would say, I went 1-3. I did win a game at least.
But you know what? I remember, Nick, you, we did those draws. Remember there was the draw prizes. And I think there was only like 5 prizes. And Nick won 2 of them.
What'd you win?
Well, I could have won. I won the one after the jersey. So I did not get the jersey.
Oh, okay.
But
did you get a brand new copy?
I could have gotten several copies of the brand new NHL 16, but instead I chose to get another, like my 4th copy of NHL 94.
In box
with the gear. Yeah,
manual.
I mean, with the manual, of course. Which I remember.
Which is still, it's worth more today.
Oh, yeah. Definitely.
If you wanted to resell.
Oh, yeah. I was
going to
say, especially 2 years from now, like that, copy will be worth way more than NHL 16.
Oh, yeah. 17 version. I have a digital copy.
Oh, yeah. Our buddy Ed, who is with us, was very bummed out that I chose NHL 94. He was seriously, he looked offended that I chose NHL 94. He was like, what's wrong with you? It's like, you could sell this right now for $40. I'm like, I don't care. Like, what are you? I want Mikey to hand me a copy of NHL 94.
I would have gave you $40 for it.
Oh my God, it was a no-brainer. Yeah. I'm like, we're at an NHL 94 tournament. There's one copy of NHL 94, and I can win it. Like, that to me is the top prize.
So, Darrell, you got the continuation of the King of 94 tournament. That's what we were talking about that me and Nick went
to. Yeah, that's what's going on.
It was basically me and Nick's King of Kong.
I
finished 13 out of 64 on the Genesis side.
Absolutely.
That's my claim to fame other than former Sonic World
Record
holder.
It's better than finishing in the top 60. That's true.
The best news that Darrell has.
I did a little better on the Super Nintendo side. I think I finished around 12th or 11th.
Hey, that's not bad, man. Especially in Canada, because the SNES is much more popular. Yeah. I was very surprised.
The King of 94 tournament is still going on.
Oh, is it really?
Yes.
Oh, it does.
We had Troy on a couple weeks ago what I like to call King of NHL 95 South, or 94 South.
Oh,
was it
95?
Sorry,
what?
I misspoke. And what's going on? What, a couple weeks?
Game.
Yeah, that's right. So in a couple weeks' time, this will be my the 4th time I've been organizing one of these tournaments. Because I helped out in the one in Toronto, too. So this will be the 3rd time I'm doing it out here. And so last year when I did it for the King of 94, it was just Sega and Super Nintendo. So that's all we did was 94. But this year I wanted to add in just a few more games and sort of called it a Retrothon mini-series. So there's going to be four competitive tournaments consisting of, well, NHL 94 will sort of be the flagship event, but then you'll have RBI Baseball from NES, Tecmo Super Bowl on NES, and then NBA Jam Tournament Edition on both systems. So it'll pretty much run the whole day from about 11 o'clock in the morning till probably midnight based on the schedule.
Oh, yeah.
And right now, I think we've got about 15 or 16 people that have already paid. Most people usually sign up within the last week or two. It's what happened last year. I think I had maybe 10 going into the last week, and then the next thing I know, it filled up just like that. So for whatever reason, I guess everyone just kind of wants to figure out their schedule, wait last minute before they do it. But it'll be a lot of fun. I got some prizes. Which I'm just going to keep as a secret because I know some of the guys are watching right now.
That's a good idea. I'll make sure they come. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah. I wonder if there's another copy of NHL 94 for Sega.
Oh, there could be. What do you
think? If you win the NBA Jam tournament.
Well, you got to get, it's like a gateway drug now.
We got there's a bunch of people flying in. So Angry Jay's flying in from California again.
Beautiful.
Which is kind of funny because last year when he won the Sega side, I had a few people say, can you not invite him back this year?
Yeah.
I said, I can't do that.
No way. So, you want it, man. You always want the best to come back.
Yeah. the on the Nintendo side, I don't remember if you remember from Toronto, but the two guys, the guy that finished second, Anatar, and the guy who finished third, Bob Kadelski, who you've met, Michael.
Yes.
Yeah, they're flying in from Montreal and Ottawa to play.
Dude, that's awesome.
And then another guy who finished sixth, his name is Smazoma, or Smaz, I call him. He finished sixth on the Sega side, so he's flying in too for this. And I was just talking to him earlier today. Actually, reminded me of a story. So back in that tournament, I don't know if you guys remember. So I was at the table and I was logging all the scores pretty much throughout the day.
Oh, I remember looking at you with just going, "Oh God, I do not envy his job right now."
So there were only two of us that had access to the site, me and Smaz. And so he was playing, and after his first game, he won 7-0. And then I didn't know this, but he went in and logged the score and gave himself a loss.
Oh, he did 0-7.
Are you serious?
Oh, man.
It's a triple elimination bracket, he had given himself a loss, didn't know that he had done this.
Oh, that sucks.
And then about halfway through the morning, he comes to me and he says, I put the wrong score in. I was kind of like looking at it. I was like, dude, then you're just going to have to carry that loss because I can't do anything now.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. That's awful. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
So, but you know what? It didn't matter because in the opening group, that was the only loss he had, and he ended up qualifying second. Michael, that if he hadn't lost that game, he would end up playing against you. Because we went back and looked against the Nebraska.
Oh, man, I would love to see that.
That maybe means I would have got 11th.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I got blown out first three games in the.
Was it?
Oh, yeah.
Is that what happened?
When I made the Sweet 16.
You did not get blown out that
one. No, yeah. You know what?
I was blown out, but I lost.
You didn't get blown out at all. I looked at the scores. They were one goal games.
Oh, yeah, they're one goal, but I lost all three games. Yeah, is what
no, I just I, remember the one game.
I know.
Yeah, that guy was awesome.
I know, and it was basically me and Nick were going to go to the one here in the States.
Yeah, yes, we definitely wanted.
But then it was also, we also purchased tickets to a Green Day concert, which we've been waiting 5 years to go, and it was the same day. And then, of course, during that week, we didn't have any plans. We couldn't change. We couldn't make travel plans. But then that concert got canceled, and we could have gone, but it was just too much short notice.
No, it was impossible. So it was like four days before.
We hope to be at the next NHL 94 tournament, and obviously not the one that you'll be at, but at least one of them for sure.
We had so much fun.
Me and Nick have been practicing on Smash TV, which is basically the exact same thing as NHL 94.
Yeah, no. Lester just basically watched Smash TV, and he's like, this should be a hockey game.
So those are the games. Where is it, and where can people find out information? Travel information, where is it being held? So those 422 people who are watching, if they can make
it. I love your paws.
My fins.
Your fins, sorry.
It's going to be played in Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, up in Canada. Say that 10 times fast.
Real quick.
Almost show.
Is there a chance that Tim Shovelday might show up?
Tim Shovelday. Wouldn't that be awesome?
It really would.
That, if you can guarantee an appearance by Tim Shovelday,
I might just quit my job and my life.
Will
to show
be
up.
There.
He is kind of our hero. So
he's from Saskatoon. No, okay, he is sorry. From go Saskatoon. On. Let sorry, people sorry. Know we're interrupting you.
We're being stupid, please.
It's on November 12th. It's a Saturday, and again, it's at a place called Bartari. It's a video game bar here in the city, which is nice because. They have all the systems that we need, tons of systems that we can play on, and I just need to bring a few extra games to it kind of thing. We're hoping that we can stream it as well, but that's kind of something that we're still have in the works. It's going to be a lot of fun. This is my fourth time doing this, so now I've kind of got it down pretty much pat to kind of run a smooth event, and it's a lot of fun. But, you know, going back to what you guys were saying about playing in the next tournament, obviously Mikey wanted to have his one this year, the second one in Toronto, but he's canceled. I don't know if you knew or not, but he's starting post-production For anybody that's watching, it's a documentary called Pixelated Heroes for the game NHL 94. So he's in the post-production that's starting up in about a week here, I think. So when that's done, I mean, I don't know how long it's going to take, but that'll be when he'll have the second tournament in Toronto because he wants to do a screening there.
And then the second tournament. Okay, because you obviously know, we talk on Facebook. As long as me and Nick have enough notice, what we would like to do, we can broadcast it here on Twin Galaxies Live, of course. As long as we have wherever the location is, if we can get a solid wired internet connection.
Yeah, no doubt.
I am putting a lot of disclaimers up here first, of course. But me and Nick would love to, at least for the finals. Stream the finals. I have a beautiful 36-inch Trinitron standard definition television here.
It is perfect.
Now,
the reason
I'm talking so much about this television,
it's a great television.
It has video in, and more importantly, it has video out. So what we can do is what we'd like to provide to the tournament, and we'll talk to Mikey.
My projector, too.
That's what because that was the one thing that I was a little bummed about the first one, is the gamers can play on a regular CRT television. It has video out, so we can take that video signal, amplify it, send it to you guys at home on Twin Galaxies Live on Twitch, and then whoever's attending the event, we can put it on a big old projector so everybody can view, because that was the one thing that I didn't get to see was the true finals of the game and how exciting. I mean, I know it wasn't the final because we ran out of time, but
I got to watch it, but I had to stand on a table.
That's
and, like,
the one
step
thing
over people.
I do want to volunteer my services. Now, the only problem is we'll set up all the stuff, but if I make the finals, somebody else is going to have to join Nick in the booth doing the play-by-play.
Luckily for me, I don't have to worry about that.
Well, let's just say this. If it's you and me in the finals,
which is won't be,
we have to commentate while we play each other.
Well,
we do that anyway.
Yeah. But that's the beauty of it, is I know for a fact I ain't making the final.
Yeah.
I'm okay as long as I don't have to score a goal. Yeah. I'm good at defense.
No,
like say,
if they had team NHL.
No, if it was team, me and Mike would win anyway.
Yeah, don't even.
I'm not
bother.
Knocking you. You are awesome, but probably not. If Raph alone is showing up, there's nothing. Yeah. There's not much.
Or Bob, or
Now there's way too many guys that are just.
Or Angry
Jay.
Angry Jay.
Now, if they change the rules to proper rules and put offsides on, then me and Mike will be in the final.
Nick, that is the worst decision ever.
Hey, I've been playing offsides since 1995.
Offsides is such a killer.
Defense wins, man. Jacques Lemaire, Jacques Lemaire, and I'm sorry. That's just the way it goes. Dave Lewis, left wing lock, man. I play
I won't spoil the ending because I know you guys weren't there, but I was in. I remember the final took place in a hotel room. And it was crazy. That's all I'm going to say is after it was over, it got pretty crazy. And you guys will enjoy when you actually watch it.
I'm excited to watch the movie to find out the end. For example, I helped Mikey shot a few scenes here in Detroit. I have a lot of footage.
Your beak is hilarious.
Backed up for him because he needed a backup.
I got it
on a hard drive. And I'm like,
oh, are you serious?
Oh, I want to watch it.
Oh, that's right. I
want to watch Mikey's footage. I'm dying. But no, that would ruin it for me because it's the one video game documentary I don't even want to be a part of it, even though I am. I want to just see it because it's my childhood. It's everything to video games to me.
Hey, I wish I would have taken Mikey up on his offer to join him, because what I did in place of watching that game was not worth it even remotely.
Nope.
Talk about a regrettable
We'll talk
night.
About that another time, because we got lots of stuff to get to.
No, but seriously, me and Mike, really, I mean, and we did some commentating over some games
there's one or
last
two
year
games,
in Toronto, which I didn't remember doing, but someone sent the link to us of us commentating over a game.
It was Darrell.
I did not remember doing that, which was very funny to watch in retrospect because I have no recollection of it. But it would be great because all we'd need really is about 20 minutes to a half hour to get up to snuff on who the teams were.
Mm-hmm,
and we could do a...
And who the people are.
No, and mainly that's the main thing. Yeah. We could do a quick 2 or 3 minute interview with both of the players, talk to them. What are you going to do? Who's the players? Are you going to do? It would be awesome. And you're right. Your TV is perfect. And oh my God, it would be a
blast. And like I said, because that, I know that was an issue, is people didn't want to play in a projector because there's some type of lag.
And there, no, and there definitely was.
I totally agree. We got the perfect TV.
Yeah, we do.
For people to play on, and then we can take the signal and broadcast it to many, many millions of viewers out there on Skype.
Several.
Which I know all you guys who tuned in are excited to see more and more NHL 94 talk from me and Nick.
Oh, yeah. Darrell, where do you think Mikey would do the premiere of this? Do you think Toronto again? Or?
Well, I like Toronto just because it's kind of like the hub, you know, of hockey. I mean, New York's people traveling from New York, Ottawa, Montreal, you know, Detroit. It's sort of almost a central location for a lot of that people to come to. Yeah, as for a venue, I'm sure that he'll want to make it as big as he can make it. So, but he hasn't said anything to me of where it would be at. So. But again, going back to the commentating, if you guys want to do it, it would be awesome. I mean, we tried to get it going last time, the stream, but I can't remember what happened.
We didn't have I can't remember her name right now.
She
was so cool. She was awesome.
Yeah, she was great.
We had a wireless internet connection. And
yeah. No, that's why we got the one game in.
Yeah.
There was one about a half hour.
And she recorded it locally.
Yes, she did. But I mean, we got the perfect connection to the television where there was one game that was able to be played that was lag free.
Yeah, that's true too.
What was her name? God, I feel horrible. I spent like 3 hours with her that day. She was so
cool. Even though if we couldn't stream it on Twin Galaxies, if we couldn't get the internet connection, we can at least record it live.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
You know, for people to watch on YouTube, just like most of you watch our show or listen to our show on iTunes.
Well, it was such a packed bar, too.
Yeah.
I mean, it really was. It was such a huge thing. It was total seat of pants.
We'll be more prepared. So
we didn't even
do anything. We were participating.
I was going to say, they just asked us if we wanted to. We did not do any prep for it. So it was kind of like
amazing job, though, as usual.
No, I was pretty thrilled. Thank you, Darrell, for sending that. I still have no memory of doing it, even though I know we did it.
It was pretty good.
Yeah. Well, cool. Darrell, thanks for coming on the show. If you want to stick around, if you could sign out and go into Twin Galaxies Live 3, if you want to just keep chatting with some of the stuff or talk about with Triforce, learn about some history about good old Walter Day. I'm sorry?
Is Triforce?
Triforce is coming on the second half of the show.
Oh, no kidding. I didn't know that.
I'm going to send you a message here shortly, Triforce, to sign on into the TG Live 2. So thanks, Darrell. Thanks again for joining us, and good luck with the tournament. We'll be anxious to see you, and we know we'll see you at the premiere.
Absolutely.
Of course, of Pixelated Heroes. So make sure you guys check that out. Pixelated Heroes, just Google it.
I like Heroes.
Sounds good. Thanks a lot, guys.
Cool, man. It's good to see you.
Triforce, if you can hear us, please sign in to Twin Galaxies Live 2 as soon as Darrell hops on out. I will send you a message right now. And now, ladies and gentlemen.
Is this Guess My Score?
Yes, it's called Guess My Score to win a used video game. It is in working condition.
It does work good, though.
We will tell
and
you.
And it is a great
we
game.
We will tell you what you've won after the fact. It might be an Atari game. It might be a brand new version of NHL 94. I mean, it might be anything. So,
Coach wants me to go back in a little bit,
So here's the rules. Right now, our chat, Nick's going to play Smash TV. Here, let me load it up.
One of the great games.
Yeah.
Everyone knows that. I mean,
there
Smash TV is an amazing
game. There you go, Nick. There you go. Look at that beautiful
face. Look at that.
Nick's going to play Smash TV here on the NES. He's not going to go for a world record.
Nope.
He's been drinking, right?
Water. I'm well hydrated.
Okay, Nick's well hydrated for tonight.
Yes.
Basically, we need you to guess his score. So we're going to give you about 35 to... I'll give you a minute to type in what you think Nick's score is going to be. Now, if you guess, whoever's closest will, of course, win. I doubt we're going to have a tie on Smash TV, but you never know.
This game
you can win that game.
Oh, this game.
It is Price Is Right rules. If Nick gets less than your guess, you don't count. So it's close.
Don't be
so
over.
If you guys, if somebody wants to guess $1 or $2,
fair bet. But I'm not gonna lie. I am pretty good.
But more importantly, please do not guess more than once. Because if you guess more than once, then I have to go through and sort which one of your guests, I will eliminate you. So, just to win a free used game, shipping included, we'll contact you via. Twitch message, I don't know, next week or something. You know, I'm a dolphin.
Whatever.
I got fins, so it's tough for
me. It's really hard for me.
So go ahead right now.
I'm going
to give you 1 minute right now because we're waiting on Triforce to sign in. put your guesses in right now.
Ooh, doo-doo. Should we do our awesome music?
Or not? Oh, yeah.
Data God, I saw that you guessed probably before I mentioned all the rules, so I will take your first guess. Oh, we don't have any odd numbers. Everybody's just giving you flat numbers, Nick.
Flat numbers?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's weird.
So,
where do some of the scores go?
Well, I don't want to tell you what the score. Well, actually, I should tell you the scores because if you beat them all, we get to keep the game.
Yes, which is the best because this game is actually kind of cool.
Is it? It gives me a headache. That's why I'm getting rid of it.
This was the game we played like a month ago. It seemed pretty fun. It was annoying, but like all games after, you know, 1997 are kind of annoying, but.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a spoiler. The game did come out after 97. Should we say what system it's for?
What? Yeah. It's for place. No, no, because then people still might not have that system.
Oh, okay.
Then they have to go to GameStop or something.
It's
like that.
For 4.
Oh yeah.
And 6.
So. Oh, okay. Triforce having a tough time getting in. Oh no.
What's the toilet?
Let's give it another 20 seconds before you start playing, Nick. So, Nick, how's your weekend going?
So far, you know what? The week was a living nightmare, but so far the weekend seems okay. You know, it's not bad.
Yeah.
It's already, the last 2 hours are better than the last month and a half. So that's good, man. And that's not, you know what? I shouldn't say that. Every Friday night is a laugh riot. Me and Mike have a really good time doing this show. We love doing this show. So obviously we thank you guys for joining us. And if this is your first time viewing us, thank you very much for joining us. Mike doesn't normally wear the dolphin uniform. This is a once-a-year thing. This is only the third time he's ever worn it. So you should feel lucky watching this because the dolphin uniform is very, very rare. I feel like it was within, what, our first 10 shows?
Yeah.
The dolphin uniform, by the way, is for Echo the Dolphin, which is obviously the greatest video game of all time
by Ed Enthusiasm.
The
greatest programmer of all time.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Even better, the programmer of the NHL 94.
Oh no, not knocking Mark Lesser at all.
No,
but Ed Enthusiasm. I mean, the picture we have alone, you can tell that is an introspective, incredibly intelligent man.
You know what?
Incredible.
You know how
man.
They have those commercials about the greatest man, the Mos Equis.
Yeah, the most interesting man in the world.
No.
He's not even close.
No, Ed.
Oh, Ed is the man.
Ed is the most interesting.
Yeah, he just lives by the
life
sea by himself.
Life form, not just human
that's
being.
That's true. That's personal.
Organ.
Ed Enthusiasm.
Ed is the most important.
I love that man.
He is great.
He is a wonderful
All right,
person.
So that's pretty much it. I'm going to cut off the guesses right now.
3, 2, 1.
Go ahead, Nick.
Done.
There you go.
Okay. Here we go. One player, one controller. All right. Man, I haven't played this game in almost a week. It's been a long time. A long time. I do love this.
Sorry, guys. We're having technical difficulties getting Triforce in. Boop, 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 boop. Oh. So, Nick, are you going to the... I guess it doesn't matter. It's not what? Like... I can talk to you, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Dude, I'm solid when it comes to Smash TV. Mm. It's basically impossible to get me off my game.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Except it got me off my game last week.
Whoa! Okay, when the vinyl died, yeah, that was...
Hello?
Hello! Triforce!
Hey, what's going on? I tried my
what's
best.
What's up, man?
That's okay. Skype's a beautiful thing at sometimes.
Yeah, it works like 18% of the time.
Here, I got an idea. I can bring your face in a different, interesting way. I'm a technical genius, maybe.
Mike is not bad at things.
Well, Triforce is a very talented gamer, has many world records on the Twin Galaxies database. He's joining us. How you doing, Triforce?
I'm doing fine. You guys can see me? The camera's working and everything?
We can see you. Our crowd can't see you, yes, but we're working in the studio. I'm trying my best to put a Band-Aid on it, but all they need is to hear us. Most people listen to us on iTunes anyway, so...
What's your face? Our voices are prettier than our faces.
So. Always.
I enjoy you guys' faces and all this stuff, so it doesn't bother me.
Well, we appreciate it.
Yeah, everyone enjoys my face with the Dolph, Echo the Dolph.
Yeah, well, it's hard not to like Echo. I mean, seriously, yeah, Echo. Like Echo. Echo, like 100 games.
Echo the Dolphin should have been the, you know, the mascot.
Oh my gosh, it's not even a concept.
Okay, let's get right to it. Triforce, what is going on in the Tumblr in a couple of weeks?
Well, Atumwa is Atumwa, Iowa is looking to celebrate its 35 years. That has a huge connection to the competitive gaming scene. They want to kind of pay homage and celebrate, you know, what I would call the Walter Day Twin Galaxies, because they're like two different ages. You have the Twin Galaxies today, which I guess we would call like the Jace Hall era, and then the Walter Day era, which was back then. So. Atumwa, Iowa is looking to celebrate and pay its respects to its contribution to competitive gaming on November 18th to the 20th. They're going to gather some of the legends that can make it out to the event, and they're going to play some games and have a good time. And there's supposed to be some type of ceremony or something, so to speak. And there's even some of the stuff that's going to be happening that involves Guinness World Records. So. Guinness World Records is going to be there. I myself, I'm trying to make it down there. I'm working with the same guys from Time Magazine and True Believer Films. Try to get a film crew to come down there and actually record this this part of history and set up something, you know, for the future for people to be able to look back, for those who weren't able to go there and so forth, but to be able to look back at what they can put together to cover the celebration of the event.
It sounds awesome. Me and Nick have been to Atumwa, I want to say too many times.
That was my answer, it's going to be too many times. But yes, we have been to
Atumwa. It's a lovely place.
Many times.
Same with Walter's hometown of Fairfield. Yep.
And Walter's home, too.
Actually, we've been in Walter's home.
Yes, absolutely. No, it's a cool place. I kind of like it, actually.
So that's very exciting. What day is the event?
November 18th through the 20th. Have you guys been in the vault of Walter's room, house, where he keeps all of his cards?
Actually, the last time we were at Walter's house was 2010.
2011. Oh, you weren't there. I was.
Yeah.
You didn't go.
He didn't have the trading cards going, but he had.
They were just starting when I was.
Did you see his newspaper collection and all that kind of stuff?
Oh, that thing's insane.
That's what we saw.
Well, he has an entire room, which we call the vault. There must at least be 50,000 cards in there, literally.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, it's called the vault.
I didn't go this year. I know you went this year to the Icon trading event. I went last year, I think. I can't remember now. It's over there. I got my 2014. I went. That was an awesome time. 14? Yeah,
his boat was pretty good back that during that time. But when in 2015, when me and Todd went there, the vault was so epic. We asked Walter, could we sleep in the vault? And when me and Todd slept in the vault room, we did not go to sleep. We probably got like 3 hours of sleep. We stood up all night going through cards that we were like, what? This exists? Cards that's, you know, on cards that's not supposed to be published, secret cards, rare cards, rare cards, rare cards. I'm like, it was literally like going through a history. His time capsule on project is ridiculous.
Did you guys sign the card that I made for Walter?
Oh, that one is so awesome.
It's like super high gloss, but it's like a little bit smaller than his cards.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
No. See, he if there's rare cards, but like the ones that he puts in the like the hardened plastic, the real hardened plastic, you have to bolt. He keeps that in a separate room. That's not actually in the vault. That's in a completely different room.
So I didn't
see your card in the vault room, but that's not because it wasn't made or anything. We didn't get to go through all 50,000 cards, so there's no way to do that.
What it is? It's actually a card of Walter, because Walter, Walter's made a few cards of himself, but he's made them for himself. No one's ever made one for him. I think I made 100 of them. I gave a few of them out that year, but there's a few copies I have. I should read what they are. It's an awesome thing what he does, and it's awesome that the history is going to be.
Is that the one that mentions soup?
It does mention about his soup making skills, Nick.
He is the king.
Actually, the one thing I did want to ask you, Triforce, was when you guys stayed in the vault room, was it like DuckTales? You know, at the beginning of DuckTales, where Huey, Louie, where they're just like swimming through the, hole. Except it's paper cards.
Yes, that's literally what they, I'm so serious. And his Makes Tracks arcade is in there.
Oh, he does?
You don't know that Wolf had a world record on Make Tracks. Well, that's in there as well.
We were there when they gave him the Make Tracks machine.
Yeah, we didn't know he went for a score.
I didn't realize he kept it. I mean, Walter was, of course, he's like the most humble guy in the world. So he, of course, was like, I'm just going to donate this. So.
Yeah, I'm going to give it to somebody else who'll play Make Tracks.
Yeah, which we were kind of like, Walter, they made it for you, dude. Like, you should probably keep it. Like,
he kept it. That was last year. We saw that last year. So I went to Icon this year, but I didn't go into the vault room. I don't know why. I just stayed upstairs the whole time. But I'm working on trying to get back. I'm trying to go back to Tomwa this year for this 35th anniversary. I'm trying to look for what I can prepare for, because it was kind of last minute, and that's one of the major issues, is that because it's last minute, a lot of people who could attend and help celebrate this historic time in history, it's just so last minute, and not a lot of people probably didn't allocate funds to be able to go. But I'm going to see what I can pull out of my, pull out of magic hat, see if I can make it. But if I do, I'll go and check the vault room and see if it's there.
Oh, you need to check.
Yeah, get one. There's 100. He probably has 90 of them. So he doesn't, unless he's giving them away. He gives cards away everywhere.
No, he does.
Your card?
It's my card, but I made it for Walter. It's Walter's face on the front. It's still the regular, the referee, his icon forever in gaming, him looking to the side. That's on the front of it. It's just a little bit narrower. It's the same height, but it's super glossy. It's glossy on both sides, and it has some poor grammar on the back. I had you check it, though.
Oh, yeah. No, you're fine.
I think it was fine.
It was all good.
You'll know. It looks completely different than the other ones, but the same.
I will definitely check after, because once I go down there, I really want to submerge myself into the whole historical essence of Ottumwa, because Ottumwa, in terms of like what it has contributed to competitive gaming, there have been a lot of bricks have been put down to help competitive gaming, in the early years, in the Wild Wild West days, but Ottumwa is like the cornerstone. And this is not true, because I don't know how a lot of people look back at the history of Twin Galaxies and they look back at the classic age of competitive gaming and so forth. A lot of people, just know Walter Day or some of the guys that were at Life Magazine or some of the players that went to the arcade. But, when you go to Ottumwa and you go there and you see the people there, there are a lot of people that helped Walter, put Twin Galaxies on the map in terms of from administration, running the arcades, helping them run tournaments. Walter did a lot of the heavy lifting, obviously, because he was the guy, he had to promote it, he had to help make the infrastructure, and did all that other stuff. But like, you'd be surprised who you find in a tumble that, the diamonds in the roughs that don't really get the airtime. And what we want to try to do is kind of, you know, get Ottumwa, Iowa that recognition it deserves for all the people who have helped make Ottumwa, Iowa, you know, the cornerstone for competitive gaming. This is why when it calls itself the video game capital of the world, it really deserves that title. And for those who are probably new to your show, wondering what is the video game capital of the world, you have to take into consideration that when they mean by video games, they don't mean by the creation of them. They mean by the competitive play of them. So if anything, it would be more properly titled the esports capital of the world, but video games is what was used back then. So
yeah, we didn't have the internet back in the day when Twin Galaxies was started. And to be honest with you, for those of us who haven't joining us for the first time, you know, you guys want to maybe watch Chasing Ghosts. Walter kind of got into, I don't want to say, Ottumwa definitely deserves to be the video game capital of the world, but it was kind of by accident because Walter one day called Williams International to find out, well, what's the highest score on Defender? And like, well, I don't know. Well, we never had that inquiry. And basically, long story short, I won't go through the whole thing. I won't spoil the movie for you. That's sort of how Walter became the official scorekeeper. He kind of kept keeping track for the manufacturers.
Speaking of he's the official keeper, there will be a ceremony. I don't want to spoil it. There will be a ceremony there that addresses that directly. So
very cool.
When it happens, I'll make sure I record it and get it to you guys so you guys can run it on the show. So for those who are not able to see it, you guys can put together a program for it for those who weren't there, and you know, send then the whole it can get out to the whole world. But if I get to go down there, I'll get that for you for sure.
Awesome. Let me interrupt our little interview here. Guess what, guys? Nick beat all your score.
Sorry.
So you guys thought Nick was a terrible gamer. Nick got 599,000 on Smash TV for NES. So none of you won the used game contest over the night. Yeah. So real briefly here, we're going to give you guys 1 minute. Nick's going to restart this game just because it's the only game. Okay. It's the only game we got in here that's kind of short, that it can be kind of random at least. Yeah. So we're going to give you guys 1 minute. Guess what Nick's score is going to be. If you go over again, yes, it is Price is Right rules. You do not, you're disqualified. So you want to guess under the score, but as close as possible. You know, maybe if somebody would have guessed $1, you guys would be the used game giveaway winner this week. But
nobody
did it. Everybody was too afraid to do the $1. So the next person would have done $2 and $3.
They wouldn't have won anyway.
Go ahead. 1 minute. Yeah. So go ahead and start making your guesses.
Should I mention my deficiency? It doesn't seem to be.
No. Okay. I wouldn't.
Okay. I mean, I'm perfect tonight.
So, Triforce, I've seen your face on CNNlately.com. I also caught part of you. You played Tetris for 24 hours, like a month or two ago. Yeah. What's wrong with that?
Well, I'm pretty much done with like competitive gaming, but something happened last year that I had retired from competitive gaming here in Jamaica. I competed in the Cyberbox Esports League, and it just so happened to just be the perfect time to step away from the game. So there was an event up here, and I won my 20th tournament straight, so I was 20-0 in the Cyberbox Esports League, and it just so happened that was the 2000th tournament for my team. So we got the world record as the most documented wins for a video game team. And along with that and being able to do that, it was suggested to me that this would be the perfect time for me to step away from esports as a competitor. Not, you know, because I'll still be involved in it, but just not a competitor. And focus more on my team in terms of just, you know, managing it and redeveloping it and, you know, getting it back to the glory days that we used to be in not too long ago. So, so what happened here was I talked to Guinness about promoting their new book, the Guinness Book of World Records 2017 Gamers Edition, and I thought it would be a great idea for them to, you know, launch the book with some type of an event that helps launch the book. And I told them that I wanted to go for a world record in Tetris. We had a conversation about it, and they said, well, what is it that I'm trying to look for? And after that was all done and deliberated, they, you know, they said, okay, fine, let's, you know, make an event out of it. And that was pretty much what that was. But it was more so to help launch the book than for me to, like, look for a world record. So, and that's what that really is, because it doesn't even go towards, like, our team's wins or anything. It was just really promotional. So, yeah. And I'm a real big supporter of Guinness World Records. Guinness World Records have been a big part of esports development for just as long as Twin Galaxies. Not exactly as long, but they put in 30-plus years as well. They were there, and they were one of the people with Williams and Nintendo and Atari and so forth that helped, you know, like, what's the word for this? Certified Twin Galaxies as the official adjudicator for competitive gaming. So I want to do everything I can to help Guinness, you know, thrive in the esports ecosystem, because they're also one of the contributing factors as to why I'm even playing games competitively, and also my team.
Yeah, and what Guinness does is very cool. Like, I love that there's a game, you know, I think part of the Gamers Edition book was, I want to say, kind of created by Walter himself with his Twin Galaxy Book of World Records. It's kind of like a continuation of it. And I know a lot of people, you know, when they see their name in print, it's a little bit different than seeing it electronically, you know. This is nothing really to joke about at this time of our presidency and what's going on with the world. But when the nukes go off,
yeah, no shit.
You know what? The database might not exist on Twin Galaxies, but that paper book that's burned and scarred,
yeah,
like when you play Fallout, you know, your name's going to be forever in the Guinness Book of World Records. When, you know, when
World
Dog comes around and reads the book.
People have to take into consideration that this isn't the first book that Guinness has been making, and although it says 10th edition on it, here's a little history a lot of people don't know. In 1983, Guinness hired Walter Day as an editor and provider of records for their books as far back as 1983. A lot of people are not aware of that. So, you know, that's something definitely, like, people have to really take, heed to in terms of the history. You know, Guinness goes as far back as possible. So I'm a huge supporter of Guinness, definitely a huge supporter of Atomos Twin Galaxies. I still support Twin Galaxies, the Jace Hall era Twin Galaxies. I still support them now. I support all forms of competitive gaming. It's only right to pay homage.
Which is nice. I mean, I agree. I know there's a lot of people that say a lot of things about the current state of Twin Galaxies, but there's still people out there competing with each other, which is all that me and Mike have ever wanted. So people can hate on it as much as they want, but it's still going on, man. So it's still the same thing. I don't see much difference.
People need to cut Twin Galaxies some slots. We're not all... During Walter's era, we didn't all agree with everything Walter was doing. During Jace Hall's era, you're not going to agree with everything that's being done. Like, nothing is perfect, but we have to give credit to Jace Hall, because guess what? He's keeping it alive. So he didn't have to. Twin Galaxies could have died 2 years ago, and that would have just been the end of it. So, you know, you got to tip your hats off to Jace. He's a big trailblazer. For esports, especially in this day and age, the man is well-versed. So he's doing things for competitive gaming in the modern aspect, and he's also helping to pay homage in the classic aspect. So you got to give your ass up. You know.
I agree. People always look at the past with rose-colored glasses. And
yeah, exactly. Come on, man. Stop that.
No, I know. And people forget that in July of 2013, Twin Galaxies was dead. It did not even exist. So the fact that anyone gives Jace crap about stuff is like, come on, man. Like, what he's put together over the last 18 to 24 months is, to me, nothing short of astonishing, because Mike and I were there during the dead time trying to put the show together, and we couldn't even put the show together.
I would pretty much be sitting in this dolphin costume.
No, it really was. It was us sitting here talking to each other going, man, I hope this works out. And there was nothing.
And we're sitting here playing mercs.
Yeah, on the dream exactly, cast. Yeah.
That's all we did.
We're all on faith that, God, I hope this Jace guy can do something.
Yeah, we didn't know who he was.
You know what it is? Put it like this. Twin Galaxies wasn't dead. They were just... They went flatline, and Jace came in with the resuscitation device, and it was like, clear.
There ain't no doubt about that, man. Jace saved this thing, and whatever people want to say, the only reason we're doing this right now talking about these scores is because of Jace.
I do want to interrupt. I am an idiot. Obviously, when you put the Echo the Dolphin costume on, you make rules for a contest, and then I don't follow them.
Oh, what'd you do, Mike?
Everybody underguessed your score. For some reason, I thought everybody overguessed your score. John Chrissy guessed 1,000 points for...
You talking about Smash TV?
Yes. Oh, okay. Everybody was on. I'm a terrible game show host.
Oh, okay.
So John Brissy, congratulations.
Oh, did
what
he?
Have you won? You have won right here. I can barely see it. Maybe I can. A used copy of Dead Island for the PlayStation 3. I hope you own a PlayStation 3, or you can trade it in. This is a beautiful copy. It's been used about twice. It comes with the booklet itself, if you're a collector of that. It's the greatest hits version. It's a little dusty, but we tested out last week.
Yeah, it was great. It was great, man.
Game gives me a headache. So
huge fan.
I'm going to pass it on to you, John. Congratulations. And make sure you guys tune in to 2 or 3 weeks. Show is for the next used game giveaway, a game we don't want. Maybe it'll be another copy of NHL 94.
Well, you said a game we don't want.
Yeah, exactly. So congratulations to John. Sorry about that, everybody. We're going to have Nick play pinball here for a little bit. But I can't obviously follow my own rules.
I've been watching the pinball the whole time.
We'll leave it on while Nick's doing that. Sorry about that, John, but good guess. Gave Ned credit more than anybody else.
No, I appreciate that.
Yeah. Yeah, Jason's done a lot, and it's been such a different change from us doing the Twin Galaxy podcast. Actually, one of my favorite, it's one of my favorite, I guess, produced shows. I love the Kong Off episode you and me did. At the very first Kong Off.
Oh, the first one.
Episode
11.
17.
Yeah, okay.
We're jumping on bushes.
Oh, yeah.
Hank Chen. But my favorite video that we did was, to be honest, I think the last time we spoke to you, Triforce, was we worked together in Chicago for just a little bit.
Are you talking about the one, the Big Bang, with the Twin Galaxies interview?
We were on the TV with Billy Sanders, Todd, a local affiliate
in Chicago.
I can't remember.
Oh, you're talking about the Council of Gaming Legends when we was on, NBC in Chicago.
Yeah, NBC in Chicago. Yes, that's the last time we spoke, but it was probably very brief. My favorite video of the produced videos me and Nick did was the Twin Galaxies gameplay. We've only done maybe 2 or 3 of them. Basically, you did an awesome job commentating on the versus Super Mario Brothers record at the time. That was an awesome video. Yeah. That's actually one of the most viewed episodes.
Really?
Is it really?
On YouTube. I don't know about iTunes.
Oh, whatever. I'll take it. That's cool.
On YouTube, it's one of our most popular. Still, the video with Walter gets, it's Walter.
Walter gets
more views. If I put Walter Day keyword, I get 2,000 hits.
Regardless.
Even if he's not in it. People are like, he's not in the video. I'm like, yeah, I know. It's called keywords.
Yes, exactly.
Oh, the clickbait.
I think it was an old record. It wasn't your current record. I think it was 2.7 million. But I never learned so much about Super Mario before than that video.
That's the no death run. That's the one you're talking about. The no death run. Yeah. So that game is. I haven't played that game in a while. Speaking of that game, so there's a ROM version of the game that was made. Someone from Twin Galaxies actually messaged me and told me that Andrew Gardicus, that's the guy who got the speedrun world record as well, that he put up 3.5 million on the the ROM, the NES ROM version. I guess this is a new variation that's being made, so forth. So, yeah, and I didn't even know that. I was like, wow, there's a ROM version out now. So, yeah, it's good games. But
it's definitely a different version, and it's you're playing it on the NES, you know. For example, that's probably why he's pretty. I mean, I know he can play the arcade one too, but like for me, I mean, I've played Super Mario Brothers. And yeah. I'm just I can't even beat the game. I know there's differences in the game, but it's like I can't play it with the joystick, or I can't play it.
Oh, I'm terrible.
I can't play it with it. Can't play with an NES Advantage. It's like I gotta play with controller.
Absolutely,
yeah. The arcade is grueling for. The arcade is grueling not because of like the slight differences between the console, and that's not the difficulty. The difficulty is the ability of standing up and playing the game, because the score I got, that's ridiculous. What I had to do was I had to learn the game in like two different compartmental phases. First, I had to learn to perfect the game, meaning I had to learn to beat the game without dying. It was very important. And once you learn to beat the game without dying consistently, then you have a good shot at getting the 3 million, because a lot of your men, you can only die four times. You can't die the fifth time. On your fifth life, you have to complete the game. And there's a way to kind of like die but respawn those men back, and with additional coin getting. This is all on like the last stage. Like anyone who plays a game professionally, from what I can remember or recollect, that's how you can get the score. And the only people I know is myself, Andrew, and I think a guy called Paul, because Paul was the first person to get 2.8 million. So like after my score, Paul had got that, but then at that time I got Andrew got 3 million first, and then I came in around and got a higher 3 million, and then I locked it up with a 3.4 million, and that's how it's been there. But like the way the game is played is you have to master not dying, and then you have to master World 8-1. That's really where the difficulty is. But like when the person told me that he got 3.5 million, they sent me a file so I could kind of look over the game, and I went over the game, his gameplay and so forth. Then the only part that's actually really important is actually the last level, 8-1, because that's where everything is determined. But I saw something that was crazy. I was like, what? You can do that? And I don't mean if you could do that like it's possible for you to do that. I wanted to know if it was even legal for you to do that, because I know you can't do any hard exploitations of the game. The rules for that game is very, very stringent. In fact, there was a time the rules were so stringent, it was like, all right, come on, this is a little bit crazy. And David Nelson had implemented a soft rule on the game just to break it up. So there's these two parts that I saw in his run. The first one is manipulating a Goomba on the top part of the first half of World 1-1, where it pushes two other Goombas to go back, and they morph. Well, they literally go through each other because they're off screen. So it's like a glitch that has the enemies go through to each other. Rather than pushing the turtle to go the other way, it makes the Goombas go past the turtle. So then when now the turtle comes ahead, you can jump and step on the turtle and kick it, and you can get an additional free man on the first board. Now, under normal circumstances of the game, that would never happen. That could never happen under any normal circumstances of the game. So I was like, why is that allowed? Now, I don't know if the rules change. I haven't played the game since I set the 3.4 million, and that was it. And once I retired, I'm like completely done. I'm trying to get some old stuff that I have archived to just get it in Twin Galaxies so I can move on with the other things I want to do in esports. So I wasn't too sure about that. I was like, that's allowed. So, you know, I knew about that trick, but I didn't do it because that was like a hard like glitch. The second part now was on 8-1-1, 8-1, where, so there's a rule. You can't step on a turtle, kick it, step on it, and kick it. because that's the turtle hop trick on a staircase. So that's the way that room works. It expresses that you can't do that. And when I did the 2.7 million, the rule was even worse. You couldn't step, kick, and step on it. You couldn't even step on it the next time. And this was at Richie Knuckles Arcade when Guinness had got the world record, and I had a big thing with David Nelson, not a negative thing, but like we had a discussion about the game moving on, and I got the world record at that time, but this is the 2.7 million at your seat that you saw that I had on you guys' show. And there was a soft, they eased up on the rule. You were allowed to step, kick, destroy, or step, kick, step. The reason why they allowed you to step on the turtle one more time is if you need it, let's say you don't have the firepower and you can't destroy it, you're allowed to protect yourself by stepping on it. But if you kicked it after you stepped on it the second time, disqualified. So they put that.
Yeah, because it's kind of a leech method at that point. I think I know what you're talking about. Me and a few buddies, on our secret Facebook chats. I got like seven of them going. Because that's one thing that I kind of noticed. I guess it's something in question. Now, like I said, I'm not a Super Mario Brothers player. But the run you were talking about, the ROM version that they have now, Andrew submitted a score. And what I noticed, and actually somebody else in our chat told me about it, is they're, in Andrew's run, he kicks it, he gets some points, and then it looks like he stomps on it to like save himself, but then it's kicked again, and of course you get more points. And me and some other buddies have kind of argued over the fact that, well, now he's kicked it again, and he got extra points because he stopped. If he stopped the I think it's a beetle in 8-1. If he stops the beetle to protect himself, but then he gets to kick it again, he gets more points than if he had the fireball and just killed the beetle straight up after protecting himself. So it was kind of like, well, if he did it on purpose or not, according to what the text says, that he kind of, in my opinion, if I'm like the judge, I think he kind of broke the rules in the ROM play. I mean, it was adjudicated as a good record by everybody in the community, but this is something I noticed and the other people noticed, well after it was approved.
There are only three that I know of. When I set the record and I left and I was done with the game, there were only two other people I know that knew how to play that game from the point standpoint. So I don't think anyone would have noticed that. And I don't know the rules for I actually should have looked at the rules set for the ROM version. I didn't look at the rules for when I saw it, I just thought, since this is the ROM version and this is a new variation, a new track, it's not the arcade. I thought you could get away with that. That's why I was like, it's whatever. I didn't know if that stood up. If the rules in the arcade stood up to the rules.
I'm pretty sure that they're the exact, I think they're copy and pasted from the arcade one. Yeah, I'm pretty positive because, I mean, the whole purpose of this awesome, to be honest, it's awesome. Now people can play the versus mode on their NESs. It's kind of awesome that somebody got the program, put it on a SD card or an own cart. But I think the Twin Galaxies database has it copy. I'm not right in front of it, but I'm pretty sure it says it because that's what we're talking about. I know it's a beetle. It's not a turtle, but that's the example.
No, the hop trick has nothing to do with whether it's a turtle or a beetle. It's just any enemy you can step on and kick. But the way what he's going for, the three of us know it. Paul, himself, and me. The way to do the trick is you're supposed to step on it for the beetle on 8-1, kick it. There is a timing that you have to do. This is where the real hard skill part comes in. You have to run behind it, stop for a little bit. You have to time it. It's like half a second. Let the beetle run. It will kill the enemies and it'll vanish off the screen, but you have to keep running. And by the time you hit ricochet, the enemy, it'll have gone past the enemies and came back and killed them, and you have to jump over it. But it's so hard to do that four times consistently. So I thought to myself when I saw it, I was like, oh, maybe he just found that way of doing it. It's easier because you can't mess that up. Like, you can just step on it, stop it, jump ahead of it, let the two enemies load, jump back over it, kick it, kill the two enemies, and just pass back, and you get your 8,000 points and your additional free. But based on the rules, you're not allowed to do that. You have to do, because when I did it, I had to get four perfect runs straight on 8-1. And it took me, when I was at Richie's Knuckles Arcade, it took me the whole weekend to do it in the arcade. I sleep in Richie's Knuckles Arcade. Like, you can ask him, the three times I went there to get those arcade world records, I slept in his arcade for the 3 days. And it was like, those are three separate events I had to go to just to get it. So it's no easy feat. You have to perfect the game, get to level world 8-1, and then those four circumstances, you have to do it four times straight. And then when you do it four times straight, then on your last man as small Mario with no power-ups, you have to beat the game. So when I did it, that's what made me go, I am done with this game. I am finished. I don't care. I was like, the score is not the best because there are certain things you can do to get 3.5 million. And I'm not talking about like the glitch in World 1, but there's another way you can get it. But to me, I was satisfied. I felt that's the best I can do. If someone legitimately beats the score, whatever, I'm fine. I'm good with it. I don't care. Guinness even gave me an actual plaque for it. I was like, it doesn't matter if it's beaten for that point in time in life. I had it. Yeah. I got it. Flawless death. You know, that's the best game I can get. So I'm happy with that.
You've gotten the record. You also then defended it with that 3.4. You know, or you got it back. I'm sorry. You know.
Yeah.
That's part of it.
But I actually, here's a story you guys don't know about between me and Andrew. Andrew actually beat me. So let me put you guys onto a story. This is between the two Super Mario Brothers giants. When we were in Richie Knuckles Arcade and Guinness was there, this is when David Nelson, this is the time when Rick Carter got the record for Q-Bert. So it was that same event that when he stood up for the marathon for Q-Bert. In that weekend, when I got the Guinness World Record, I got the 2.7 million, me and Andrew made a bet. And the bet between the two of us was who can score 3 million points first in versus Super Mario. And he got the 3 million before me. So in that regard, he beat me. That was like the challenge between the two of us. And he actually got the 3 million points ahead of me. And then I got like 3.3, and then I got 3.4, and then I was, that was it for me. I was pretty much good with that.
That's very cool.
So awesome. Even though I got the record, he actually beat me.
He beat you. Well, that's like the head-to-head. That's like the creation of the dunk.
Absolutely. You
know, I think Billy Mitchell said it best. It's like, well, it's great that you're the best of all time, but can you be the best this weekend? Can you be the best next weekend?
Yeah.
That's the key right there.
For example, me and Nick were talking about our friend Halifax. You know, NHL 94. NHL 94, there is a biggest blowout track. But that's kind of, you know, in a sports game, that really doesn't prove who's the champ. It's more of a head-to-head game, you know, and that's why there's always tournaments and, you know, and I love the way that some of the classic arcade community is, you know, it's not just world record chasing. We can turn things into tournaments, like Battle of the Arcades and the Kong-Offs, and I know there's other events, you know, Nibbler, the past Nibbler tries. That's kind of head-to-head, kind of gone in for the world record, but that's what's awesome.
No, it's like getting a perfect game in baseball. Don't get me wrong. The list of no-hitters is solid pitchers. The list of perfect game pitchers, it's flukes.
Yeah.
Most of the guys are like, who are these people? It's because when it comes to stuff like that, like biggest blowout, usually it's not the best player.
Yeah.
It's usually some crazy set of circumstances happened for them always that day. I'm not knocking them. I'm not saying they're bad. They're obviously good enough to do it, but something happened that day, whether it's fate or just weird circumstances, that they just had a great 45 minutes.
That's how it goes.
That's just how it goes sometimes, man. That's just the way it is.
Greg Maddux never had a no-hitter.
Yeah.
He's the best pitcher I've ever seen in my life. But he never had a no-hitter. So what are you going to do?
Cool. Awesome. Well, thanks, Triforce. I don't know if you had anything else. I know Twin Galaxy is telling us we should.
They're yelling
probably,
at us. Right,
they gave us some extra time this week.
No, but thanks for coming on,
thanks,
man.
It's definitely interesting. I know I kind of went off subject there. I was kind of talking about the time we did the podcast and how we want to continue shows like that.
Yeah.
But, you know, I guess one thing I did want to say coming down to it is I kind of want to see certain things like that revisited. I'm in question, and I guess that's what I'm kind of uncomfortable about Twin Galaxies. And I know Jace is working his butt off, trying to make everything legit and transparent. You know, there's improvements, yeah, and then there's things that aren't improved. But, you know, Jace told us the very first days before the adjudication even came in
way before.
You know, there's going to be an adjudication by the community. I think there needs to be I'm thinking a re-adjudication.
No. There should be a verification.
Certain
process.
Things come up later.
Yep.
And this is the purpose of the Twin Galaxies Archive, is to, if somebody wants to see why somebody was the world record, they can go back and look at the evidence package. And me and a couple of my buddies, you know, we kind of look at Andrew's run, and of course we're impressed as hell as it, but I mean, of course I'm not, I was head referee for 12 days. We're not gonna get that discovers. But I didn't know enough about Super Mario Brothers. I still don't, but I kind of think that Jace needs to, as much as all the good stuff he's doing, I think that the challenge system that he talked about, I'm hoping that's like next on the priority list, because this is a small example.
Things change.
But how I kind of want to say, like, the way the Constitution is interpreted, it changes as time goes on, but does it need to be reevaluated at certain times? So I don't know. I don't know if Jace is listening or not. Who cares? But
no,
maybe the community wants to get around that. But they're, I believe, because now right now it's
an
like
elastic clause.
It's adjudicated. It's a world record from here and forever. But if something else, somebody else points something else out afterward, or an expert comes along that's been dormant, that, for example, is sick or has been away from Twin Galaxies, trust me, there's days where I don't even want to go to the Twin Galaxies website.
Oh, God, no.
But there's consequences to that, too. If you're part of the, you know, maybe one of the reasons you're retiring officially, you know.
Just, I'm retiring because, to be honest with you, I had to retire. I had to go because what was going on, for those who follow Empire Arcadia, I was losing a lot of my players. I can't focus on competitive gaming. I'm 39. I just look young, but I'm 39. And I have no children, and I'm trying to get my personal life back together. I do a lot of traveling and stuff that I'm helping Walter with, stuff that I'm trying to help just the overall esports scene globally. You know, here in Jamaica, I'm actually here in Jamaica working to help put Jamaica on the map in the esports ecosystem. I'm next trying to go to Africa. So these things that I have, I'm sorry for the dog barking in the background, but that's actually outside. It's just very loud. But I don't have the time to sit down and be able to play the games the way I used to back then. And I just don't. It's like Billy Mitchell. If you really look at Billy Mitchell, when he goes to the Kong Off, you know, it's the Billy that's at the Kong Off today is not the Billy that played Donkey Kong then. It's definitely not. You know, trust me.
Yeah,
not even
life changes all of us, but more importantly, he needs to make that hot sauce.
Yeah, the hot sauce.
Because what he does to me? He provides me a better benefit of making me hot sauce.
Oh, yeah.
Than what me watching him play Donkey Kong.
Anyone can play Donkey Kong. No one can make
my understanding,
hot sauce
he
like
has
Billy
the
does.
Base for Buffalo Wild Wings Spicy Kong.
Yeah.
So that's more important than playing Donkey Kong. So, but that's awesome. So. That's awesome, Triforce. Thanks for coming on the show tonight.
No problem.
A lot of fun.
Hope you get to make it to Ottumwa. I know we can't make it.
No, unfortunately.
To the 35th anniversary. If you guys are local.
We were there for the 30th.
We were there for the 30th. Make sure you guys can search it on Facebook. Just 35th Twin Galaxies anniversary. Get the information. Hit up Walter on Facebook. He'll gladly instant message you need to know. And maybe he'll give you guys maybe if you visit, he'll let you go through the vault.
I know. I'm kind of jealous. I want to go to that thing. Huh?
Swimming for cards.
It's so cool.
Yeah. You know what? Sav2880. Yeah, you love that idea. It almost feels like there should be a commissioner that oversees maybe a group of trusted refs. I've been saying it for months. There needs to be a commissioner.
Maybe for years, actually.
For years, I don't know. There needs to be a commissioner who can't participate in gaming, who can't make the rules for a game, but can definitely interpret the rules and do stupid, silly things like organization of the database. But
whatever.
You guys can talk about that out before.
Whatever.
Yeah, Supreme Court
would be great too. You know?
But we'll continue that argument for the next weeks to settle it on the screen as I lobby and lobby for a commissioner. Even if I don't want to do it. I just
thank you guys for having me on, man. I really appreciate it. And thanks to all the people who are actually watching. So I appreciate that as well.
No problem. Thanks, Triforce.
Thanks a lot for coming
on the show. So for my host, Nick Auslander, thanks for Darrell coming on. Michael Stroka, Echo the Dolphin. Just a little programming note. We need to switch with Jace Hall. We need to go on opposite weeks so we can get Glenn in here, our other co-host.
Yeah,
so I don't know when our next show is going to be. I don't know if we'll be on next week. I don't know if we'll be on 2 weeks. I don't know if we'll be on 3 weeks. I don't know if we'll be on all 3 weeks. So make sure you stay tuned to our Facebook channel. We do need to switch that so we can get Glenn back in here, start swearing and all that good stuff, and an actual gamer who's actually really good at gaming other than me and him. So stay tuned for that. And we did promise, and when we have a concrete schedule of when our next show is, I plan to make it the Golgar show we've been talking about.
I know, we've been teasing.
We will get my pinball machine in here, and we're going to play some Golgar.
Yeah, we will.
And we'll probably do a, another used game giveaway.
Yeah, we could go. We have plenty of games to sell. So.
Yeah, so for everybody helping us, all the guys at Twin Galaxies Live who run our show every time we do it, thank you so much. And we'll see you, and make sure you settle it on the screen. Peace. Good night, everybody.
Happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween.
Everybody.